this is how I look at it. For men who want to identify as women, they want access to the locker rooms, the dressing areas, the bathrooms. And they say it is because they feel uncomfortable. Men identifying as women using the men's restroom, the men's locker room, the men's dressing areas. It makes them feel uncomfortable. They're worried about their safety. A lot of women, most that I know, including some pretty lefty women, are very nervous about men who identify as women because just because they might say that they're transgender does not change who they are attracted to sexually. Those are two different things, and those are their definitions. That is what that community has endlessly said. A man who identifies as a woman going into the female bathroom, a lot of women, most women, feel very uncomfortable with that. They are uncomfortable. They are worried about their safety. But society only tells one of these two parties to shut up. Society tells the women, years and years and years of quote-unquote feminism has brought us to the point where society will tell women who are concerned about their comfort, women who are concerned about their personal security, women and girls. Society tells them to shut up, smears them as bigots for having the audacity to be worried about their safety. They are accommodated. Are not accommodated. The man is accommodated. The women are not. That is the point. That is sexism. That is the patriarchy. Women and our comfort and our security, we have every right to be comfortable and feel secure when we are using a restroom in the public restroom. We have every right as women to feel comfortable and secure to change in a locker room. And what amazes me is that these same people who are telling women to shut up and deal with it are also the same damn people that tell us we as women are too stupid to carry guns. In no way do they want us to be able to defend ourselves. The men are accommodated. The women are told to put up with it. For years, I was told, not just by family members, but by society, by entertainment, by books, if you feel that a situation is weird, listen to your gut. I remember all these after-school specials and stories and stuff from, you know, family members and other adults. You know, if you're at a party, you know, you're at a teenage get together, you're at a party as a young adult, whatever, and it gets out of hand and you feel uncomfortable because you feel like something could go sideways, get out. If you feel uncomfortable because you don't like a way a man is looking at you when you're, you know, out in public and you're, you know, you're kind of looking over your shoulder. How many of you have seen those scenes in movies where a woman is walking down the street? It's in like every movie. And she's looking over her shoulder. She's followed by a guy. Listen to your gut instinct. She takes defensive maneuvers. Situational awareness. I've gone through classes on situational awareness in all of the hours of self-defense courses that I've taken. And now, after all of this, women are told to put that aside. How dare you, women, feel that you are uncomfortable or that you are unsafe. You are the bigot for feeling unsafe. Imagine you're a teenage girl in a locker room. I had a cousin on my husband's side that went through this in their school. 18-year-old male who just that year decided they were going to identify as a female, but only outwardly. Wanted to be able to change in the girls' locker rooms. He was offered the accommodation of the teacher's bathroom, the faculty bathroom, which was literally a one commode room. And, you know, that wasn't good enough. Wanted the women's locker room, insisted on going in there. Being an adolescent girl is a challenging enough period. And I would imagine it's the same for boys when you're in locker room situations. Everybody goes through that. It's like that rite of passage. Your muscles are compared. For girls, that's just the way it is. Girls are uncomfortable anyway. Boys feel uncomfortable anyway. You got to get to a certain point. And even then, everyone always practices, you know, you pay attention to your own locker. It's not like, some of the rock videos where they have the women just hanging out, like in the 80s movies, how the girls all hang out in the locker room like that. It's not like that. But it's tough, especially when girls are going through that period of adolescence and they're growing and everything's awkward. And then to throw into the mix what technically was in that situation, an adult male. Which that would, in any other regard, that would be a statutory offense. But now we're legitimizing it. And we're legitimizing shaming women. And we are legitimizing the facilitation of preying on women. For what? For wokeness? I wasn't surprised when there was all this talk of, you know, well, if men have to sign up for the draft, make women sign up for the draft. I wasn't surprised to see that in a nation that now apparently thinks that women have no right to feel secure in their own person, that women have no right to be safe in their area, that women have no expectation of security, safety, and or comfort because their concerns are less than. It is the most patriarchal and offensively sexist BS that has ever been unleashed against womankind.